Good morning, everyone. Hello, students. So again, we are here with your commerce class. So as we all have discussed about line and staff organization yesterday, so today all the organization structures we'll complete, and the last one which we have to discuss today is divisional structure. So today's topic is divisional structural organization. So before discussing the divisional structure, let us first go through the learning objectives of organizing. First of all, it is aids to management, then facilitates growth and creativity, ensures optimum use of resources, establish relationship among individual groups, cluster job into units, coordinates, perform an analysis about the work, identifying the work and communicating by grouping of activities for attaining objectives and assignment of work. So as per your mind map, the concepts which you have to cover in this chapter, you have covered meaning, importance, steps, line organization, formal and informal organization, line and staff organization, functional organization. So today we are going to cover divisional structural organization. And then we are left with just two topics, delegation and its part, centralization. So when you discuss about divisional organization structure, the very first example which comes across my mind was Pepsi cooperative structure. Pepsi Corporation, you all know, because you all take cold drinks, and Pepsi is one of a very good beverages company. It has a global division. It is not limited in India. It has many divisions. It not only produces or manufactures a drink, rather it also deals with other homogeneous products with differentiated features. So when we talk about global divisions of Pepsi, first we have North America Beverages, that is NAB. Then we have Frito-Lay's North America, that is FLNA. Then Quaker, you all know Quaker Oats, Quaker Food Products, Quaker Foods North America and Latin America. Quaker Foods has two divisions. Then they have Asia, Middle East and North Africa. Then another is European Sub-Saharan Africa, ESSA. Okay, can anyone guess what is the outcome of this example? What we are concluding? In a divisional structure, your business is expanded worldwide. You have divisions of homogeneous products with differentiated features, and they are expanded, spreaded zonal wise and area wise, region wise. So why a divisional structure is done? Its learning objective is to describe the basic premise behind divisional structures and within the general framework of the organization. So let us introduce a new example again. Another example of GNU, GNU Health Design, GNU Health Core Module. Now this unit, a medical unit, this has many divisions. Its design is a modular design having many modules. So divisions are also called modules. So here we can have pediatrics, surgery, radiology, hemato, oncology, hospitals, socioeconomics, laboratories, localizations, epidemiology, genetics, family and many more. So what are these? These are the different divisions of GNU Health Center, which has expanded the services it provided. So it creates departments, and moreover it has regional and zonal offices as well. So do you all remember these logos? every company has a branded logo of it. So Samsung, LG, Will's Lifestyle, Guard, these few companies, they observe divisional structure. Divisional structure is not followed in small organizations, it is followed in big companies and in associations and groups also. So let us take an example of Department of Energy. Department of Energy, United States of America. This is a departmental staff and support officers. It is having, in this department, you can say they have Federal Energy Regulatory Commission, Office of the Secretary, and its name is Dr. Stephen Chu. He's a deputy secretary there, chief of all staff. Then they have a list of deputy administrators for defense programs, for defense nuclear proliferation, for naval reactors, for counter-terrorism, for defense nuclear security. Other than that, they have the office of Under-Secretary for Nuclear Security Administrator for National Nuclear Security Administration, Thomas P.D. Agostino. He has another division, Legacy Management, Office of Under-Secretary, Office of Under-Secretary for Science. For Science, they have a division of Fossil Energy. Another, they have a division of Energy Efficiency and Renewable Energy. So, in this Department of Energy, we can see that they have several divisions and every division has a head. So, they have splitted one Department of Energy into different autonomous units. Okay, let's see the key terms which we'll be covering under this topic with suitable examples. First of all, first is division. Splitting up an organization into semi-autonomous units. Semi means which are not fully independent because their authority ultimate lies with top management. The divisions. Next we have competing interests. First of all, focusing on specialized efforts for a particular product, service or market. For example, in an automobile manufacturing, one may create a car division, a truck division, a minivan division and a SUV division. It can be created for geographic markets such as North America, Europe and Asia. So what is company doing here? Competing interests of customers. Next key term is silo. S-I-L-O. In business, a particular unit or a department within which communication and collaboration occurs vertically with limited cooperation outside the unit. Example, production, sales, marketing, finance. So every department or every functional unit is called a silo. Next we have retail division. Focusing on all commercial customers, product development, production, retail customers in US, accounting and sales employees. So retail division is what? A term used to reach ultimately to the targeted customer. That is called retail division. Or we can also say a very good example of it is, say we have Bata shoes. You have Bata showroom outlets. It's a company, shoemaking company. It has its retail divisions. So what is it? A retail division for the targeted customer. Next is parent company, an entity that owns or controls another entity, a group which holds another group, a group which has branches is called a parent company. For example, Virgin Mobile and Virgin Records. Next we have subsidiary, A company owned by a parent or holding company use the brand name and capital of parent company, that is called a subsidiary company. So, for example, like your own school, Holy Heart Presidency School, one branch is at GT Road, Super Kids is another branch. So, parent company is one, the name, that is the Holy Heart, its branches that are subsidiary companies. Next is departmentation. The organization of something into groups, activities into groups according to their function, according to the geographic location, that is called departmentation. North zone, south zone, east zone, west zone, so this is departmentation. Next is flattachi, blending a flat structure and allowing more decision making among the different level organization, that is called flattachi. Flattachi is a flat structure where you can have more divisions for decision making among the different levels of organization, top, middle, lower. For example, flattachi is followed in Google, Adobe, LinkedIn. So these are the few official organizations following flattachi structure, also called divisional structure. So what is a divisional structure now? A structure where activities of an organization are grouped into number of divisions. Every division is generally created on the basis of product, and every division contains all the necessary resources and functions as well, like own production department, own finance department, marketing department, within the support of a particular division. For example, a big company having a diversified product line, say cosmetics, medicines, garment, footwear. So this company is dealing with these kinds of products and its subdivisions. Under cosmetics, it will have purchase, production, marketing, finance. Same in medicine division, it will have purchase, production, marketing, finance. And also in the case of garment and footwear also. Let us first discuss the features of divisional structure. So first is segmentation. All the activities of the organization are grouped and divided into smaller parts known as segments, and this process is called segmentation. There is degree of autonomy. Autonomy means independence. Every division is an independent unit to work of its own. There are particular markets in divisional organization structure. Different markets are there. Like we were discussing, we have cosmetic market, footwear market, garments market. So for different products, different markets. They focus on product lines. Now if you go for garments, may they be ready-made garments, and then go for ready-made garments, they are having men products, they are having women products, they are dealing in kids products. So different product lines under one division. In divisional structure, there are operated chain stores. As we are taking example of Bata, so a chain store is there, opened in different localities under one name, brand name, and one capital logo also. They have international subsidiaries. So generally MNCs follows divisional structures like McDonald's, Domino's, KFCs. So they are international subsidiaries. Let us now discuss the types of divisional structure. One is product divisionalization, another is territorial divisionalization. Product divisionalization is division on product only. It's a self-contained division. In territorial division, functioning in different areas, in different territories, that is territorial divisionalization. So let us first discuss territorial structure. Railways, banks, insurance company, transport companies, these are the very good examples of territorial structures. Here, CEO is there, corporate managers are there, but the all activities are divided in zonal and regional offices located northwise, west side, south and east. So, dividing the work as per territory is called territorial structure. When we talk about product divisionalization, so suppose the company has three products, cosmetics, pharmaceutical, textile. It may have further divisions, purchasing, production, marketing, personnel, finance. Then again, purchasing, production, marketing, personnel, finance. Same follow purchasing, production, marketing, personnel, finance for all these three departments separately. If they extend their products, suppose now they have also started with washing machine division, television, lighting division, but the other number of divisions, the sub departments, purchase, production, marketing, personnel and finance will remain same. A good example of product divisionalization is your own well-known luxury sedan divisions, SUVs. So now the next is merits of divisional structure. First is integration. Divisional structures integrate all activities related to a particular product line. They reduces the problem of coordination between production and sales activities with respect to a product. Divisional organizational structure attentively focus on every individual product, make the product expansion and diversification easy. In this, top management fix responsibility for performance of each division with their heads, and the performance ultimately contributes to overall results. In such a division, they call for different functions, and top management position help the semi-autonomous nature of every division to promote more initiatives. In this divisional structure, they are flexible and adapt to business environment as well. So, they also help in faster decision making. Let us now also discuss about demerits of divisional structure. First is expensive. This division maintains its own facilities, own employees, so there is duplication of physical facilities and functions as well. So they increases their operating cost. In this particular division, plant capacity remain underutilized because every product has its own plant installation. There can be conflicts between different divisions due to the use of funds and resources. Moreover, there is no centralization, and the functions like accounting and financing got disturbed. In this divisional structure, the future aspect of achieving the organizational goals becomes difficult. So it has a narrow approach. For example, finance personnel in one division does not communicate with those in another division. Another problem arises because of tax implications. These are the few demerits of divisional structure. Now, where is divisional structure suitable? It is suitable for large organizations which have varied product line. They require manufacturing, they require technology, they require methods with a high degree of specialization. Divisional structure aims at meeting expectation of local populations. Big companies manufacture more than one product or operations in different geographical areas, which lead to divisional structure. Here, homogeneous products with a wide variety of differentiated products are produced under different origins and different areas. A very good example is Reliance Group, like clothing, communication electronics. So they have different divisions worldwide operating and meeting the expectations of local population. So we can say that divisional organization structure organizing the activities of a business around geographical, market or product or service groups. It is a type of organizational structure that groups each function into a division. Every division contains all the necessary resources and functions within it to support that product, line or geography. For example, having owned a divisional structure gives a large business enterprise the ability to segregate large sections of company's business into segments. Do given the following links, refer the following links for more clarity of the concepts and read the page 236 till 238 of your book. Also answer the following questions. What is divisional structure? Give its merits and demerits. Write all the key terms which we have discussed in this particular topic. Thank you.